And Russia is being investigated for possible war crimes after increased evidence its forces are targeting civilians. Not shells that have gone astray, but repeated fire on apartment buildings, schools and homes. The intensified attacks coming as peace talks stalled.
One after another, they fell. What are believed to be so-called cluster bombs, munitions containing multiple explosive devices banned by many countries, dropped on Kharkiv, Ukraine's second largest city. Here, a shopping centre is destroyed, houses and apartment blocks decimated, schools too. It was a relentless bombardment with civilians seemingly in the firing line.
This is a residential area with no military objects.
A rocket speared a huge hole through this unit. Somehow it did not explode. But another did when it slammed into the ground outside this woman's apartment. Her leg was blown off. She did not survive. The Russians claim they're not targeting civilians. But tell that to the mother of this six-year-old girl, rushed to hospital after a Russian airstrike on a village near the city of Mariupol. Doctors and nurses did all they could to save her. It was a fight they could not win. Here is the aftermath of the airstrike that killed the child. It's clearly a residential area. This woman lived in one of these houses. She was buried under the rubble.
I have lost everything. It was all blown to smithereens. I was covered in blood.
The human toll evidence, Ukrainian authorities say, that what's happening in this country are war crimes.
This is the action of a state determined to kill civilians. There is no debate. These are war crimes.
The International Criminal Court is now investigating. The intensified bombing came as Ukrainian delegates travelled to the border with Belarus for peace talks with Russia. There was no resolution. The Ukrainian president saying fair negotiations can take place when one side doesn't hit another one with rocket missiles during negotiations. While both sides have agreed to meet again, there's no sign Vladimir Putin is contemplating a ceasefire, sending more troops towards Kiev and painting himself as the victim. Once again isolated from his own ministry, blaming the coming economic collapse on anyone but himself.
We are talking here about the sanctions that the so-called Western community, the empire of lies as they call it, are trying to impose on our country.
Putin is clearly frustrated. The war is not going to plan. He hadn't expected this. Ukraine's volunteers, the ragtag army of amateurs signing up to fight. This man, a fisherman.
Have you ever used a gun before? Have you ever had to be in this position before?
No.
Volunteers handed free Kalashnikovs, like the SES, with guns. Here, 22-year-old master's biology student, Ksenia.
This is dangerous. You could die doing this.
I know. If I die, I die.
Wow.
She's doing it for mum.
She's scared?
No.
She proud?
Yes.
They're manning the roadblock on Kiev's major southern entry point, mixed with regular army, so many of them so young. This 25-year-old was a computer programmer.
Are you scared? Maybe.
Then a shout. Everyone is running for cover. One runs to grab me. We're headed for the concrete shelter. In Ukraine, volunteer lifesaving is at another level.
Volunteers just scattered here for cover because the alarm had gone off that an aerial attack was imminent. They wanted to get under this concrete shelter.
The threat passed for now, but they're ready to die for this land.
That's how much it means. The 1 million strong Russian army dwarves Ukrainian regular forces 5-1. They need the numbers that the volunteers provide. A surprise force that has astonished the world, especially the Russians.
A community rallying with whatever they have. Here, a drive-by Molotov cocktail launched at a tank. Peaceful resistance too. These Russian soldiers surrounded by the locals of Berdyansk shouting, "Domoy, go home." The Russians retreated, but who knows for how long.
And let's go live to Chief Correspondent Chris Reason in the capital, Kiev, now. Chris, there's a new recruitment drive underway to bolster those Ukrainian troops.
That's right. Good evening to you, Fergo. President Zelensky has now announced that he's going to open up the nation's prisons and release the prisoners to the front line, saying they can serve out their obligation to the country by joining the struggle for its freedom. Now, desperate times call for desperate measures, but they will be needed. We've just received this vision in from Ukraine's second city of Kharkiv. A government building completely obliterated by Russian Grad missiles just in the last couple of hours. Big advances too from the Russians in the south, as in other parts of the country, including here in Kiev. Large areas being blanketed with snow now, just to make life that little bit more difficult as the country enters its sixth day of war. Mark?
Chris Reason in Kiev for us. Thank you. Scott Morrison has taken the extraordinary decision to supply lethal weapons to Ukraine in the fight against Russia. Tens of millions of dollars worth of missiles will now be sent to the conflict zone as Australia rallies in defiance of the Kremlin.
Australia's iconic landmarks bathed in Ukrainian blue and yellow, a colourful display of solidarity as the Prime Minister chooses colourful words.
Australia will always stand up to bullies.
Cabinet's National Security Committee deciding to significantly ramp up support for the Ukrainian army with lethal weapons.
We're talking missiles, we're talking ammunition.
$70 million for those missiles, ammunition and body armour, and $35 million in humanitarian assistance to help the millions flooding into Poland. The missiles, believed to be shoulder-fired javelins, used effectively in recent days to take out Russian armoured vehicles heading towards Kyiv, and anti-tank missiles bought through NATO.
And I won't be giving Vladimir Putin any heads up on how it's getting there, but it's coming, I can assure you.
Defence Minister Peter Dutton's warning the worst may be yet to come, that having failed to exert military dominance thus far, Vladimir Putin might now be planning to unleash almighty hell on Ukraine's cities.
Russian troops can be particularly brutal, and I think people should brace themselves for what we're going to see out of the Ukraine in the coming days and weeks.
Scott Morrison suggesting Russia should be banished from the G20 and other international forums.
They have self-selected themselves as a pariah state, and no one should have anything to do with them, frankly.
Australian liquor outlets demonstrating that, taking Russian vodka off the shelves. Mark Riley, 7 News.
Before those Australian-funded weapons arrive, the Ukrainians will receive $700 million worth of weapons and equipment funded by other European countries. While they wait for those stockpiles to reach them, ordinary citizens are making their own, and they're proving very effective.
A bottle of beer becomes a bottle of fear. Ukraine's citizen defenders are reaching back into history as they confront its marauding neighbour, Russia. Molotov cocktails or bottle bombs, unconventional weapons in the hands of unconventional troops. These men, learning how to extract a possible enemy from a vehicle. They come from all walks of life to be soldiers in the defence of their country.
Whenever the soldiers are coming to your land, to your city, and they are shooting your kids and the civilians, then everyone is doing what he can do the best.
Molotov cocktails is one way they're fighting back. They were making and stockpiling them here at this craft brewery.
We would love not to need to go to the hideouts every time that we have sirens. But we need to be ready, and we are ready.
The labels on the bottles are leftover from the last time Russia invaded Ukraine in 2014 in Crimea.
And what's that message there?
It's Putin Huilo, which is Putin is a cat.
There are 400 bottle bombs in that collection there, but they've made thousands of them, and they've been distributed all over Lviv. In Lviv, Ukraine, Jeff Parry. 7 News.
Russian troops are now using new tactics as they face Ukrainian resistance. Mike Amor has the latest on how this war is unfolding.
Mark, the toll from this war grows by the hour. In the first 5 days, Ukraine was hit by 56 missile strikes and 113 cruise missiles fired. Ukraine claims 5,300 Russian troops have been killed, though that's not been verified. Russian ground forces are advancing on four areas: Kiev, the Northeast Front, Donbass and Mariupol in Crimea. Troops have advanced about 5 kilometres on Kiev in the past day and are still 24 kilometres from the city centre. Heavy artillery is being used in urban areas like Kharkiv, meaning we are now entering a dangerous new phase of the war.